वेलकम माई डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ अंडरस्टैंडिंग HTML. दिस इज़ द चैप्टर नंबर 10 फ्रॉम योर बुक. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द HTML, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द HTML, स्ट्रक्चर, वट आर द टास्क, हाउ कैन यू क्रिएट एंड व्यू योर HTML डॉक्यूमेंट, वट टाइप ऑफ टास्क यू कैन यूज इन योर डॉक्यूमेंट, वट आर द एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ द टैग एंड हाउ कैन यू चेंज द अपेयरेंस ऑफ द वेब पेज दैट यू आर क्रिएटिंग, मीन्स द फॉन्ट, द बैकग्राउंड कलर, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू अटैच एनी इमेज इन योर बैकग्राउंड. सो हाउ कैन यू डू दिस? सो नाउ स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर, द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट इज वेबसाइट एंड वेब पेजेस. वॉट इज वेबसाइट? वी आर ऑल अवेयर ऑफ द टर्म वेबसाइट बिकॉज नाउ अ डेज we are all surfing a various number of website in our daily uses. For example, for the study point of view, many students are nowadays browsing a website for the CBSC for the result. For the shopping sites or for the online grocery shopping, we are all browsing Big Basket, Grofers, Amazon, Flipkarts, and many other website are also available on the internet so that you can surf and gain information or the gain articles from the net. So with a simple definition, we can say that website is a collection of the web pages. Means if we are linked web pages that are containing the information about the same type, then this type of web page is called collection of the web pages are known as the website. So what are the web pages exactly? So a particular page that is available on the internet and containing some text, image, it may contain some type of audio, it may contain some type of video. So everything can be accommodated in a web page. And similarly, a web page is created with the hypertext markup language, that is your HTML language. So according to your need and requirement, HTML can provide you various type of tags. With the help of those commands, you can create your own web page. So a website is a collection of the web pages, and the very first page that opens when you open a website is called the home page of your website. For example, you had opened the Big Basket website and the first page that is open on your phone, on your laptop, is called the home page. And home page can contain various links to the various other web pages, and you can open the web pages by clicking on it or by entering your search requirement in the search toolbox. So in a short, what is website? Website is a collection of web pages. What are the web pages? Web pages is a e-page, or you can say a particular page available on the internet having some text, audio and video files. And in a website, each and every web page are interlinked with the help of the hyperlink. You all are studying hyperlink in your class 6 and 7. So a hyperlink is a type of link which connect two or more web pages together. Now your next topic is web browser. So what is web browser? Web browser is simply a software that is installed in your phone and in your laptop through which you can open a website. Normally you have heard various type of web browser like Chrome, that what you are using in your phone, Internet Explorer like Emacs, and the icon of the Chrome is a colorful circle and sort of, and UC browser, we were previously using it in the phone, basically Opera. So these type of web browser, with the help of these browser, you can open the website. First of all, you will have to click on the web browser option, and in the address bar, you have to just enter the address of the web page or the URL of the web page which you want to open. And when you click on the enter button, the web page or the website will open. So in a simple definition, what is web browser? Web browser is a software through which you can open your website. The main point to be remembered is that the first web browser was invented by Sir Tim Berners-Lee. An important question for examination point of view, that who has invented the first web browser. So Sir Tim Berners-Lee has invented the first browser, and when it is invented? It is invented in 1990. Starting with the HTML, what is our topic for the today. So the full form of the HTML is the hypertext markup language, and each and every word that is in abbreviation HTML has its own meaning. And now I am going to discuss every word one by one. So listen it carefully. The first word is H. H means hyper. Hyper means a hyperlink. Means a blue color text on which if you click, it will redirect to you a new page. Or simply you can say, by clicking on a blue link or the blue line, you will open a new page. So H is a hyperlink. H means hyperlink. T for text means HT. If you combine, it becomes a hypertext. And the hypertext means you can create hyperlink with help of HTML language, and with the help of the hyperlink you can combine more than one pages together. The second is the markup. M for markup, and markup means using of tags in the HTML language is simply known as the markup. In the coming slide I will discuss about the tags. And L is a simple language, a type of coding or a type of command. So with the help of this language you can create your own web page and publish it in the website, or you can publish it on any server. So what is HTML? The full form of the HTML is the hypertext markup language, means with the help of this language you can create your own web page having the hyperlinks, having some text, having some video, having some audio also. And what is the extension of HTML page? The extension of the HTML page, there are two extension is given, that .html or .html. Extension both can be used with the HTML page. And when you create a page with these two extension or with any one of these extension, your page look like a web browser. And after saving the page with the help of HTML extension, you can open it on the web browser. So this is about the HTML. Now I am going to discuss about the characteristics of the HTML. So HTML is easy to understand. It is simply look like English like language. When you start coding, you will feel like that you are simply writing a text in your copy. And it is very flexible, and with the help of this HTML, you can create your own web page. The second point is that with the help of this language, you can accumulate all types of files like picture file, graphic file, video file, sound file and the text file together in a single web page. So as I had told you earlier, that a web page contain all these types of files. So you can do it with the help of HTML language. The third point is that many formatting effects can be used for powerful web pages, means with the help of the web page you can enhance the look of your web page. So your web page should be more impressive and should be more communicative, as you can use different type of formatting techniques in your page. The next point is that you can link all the web pages together. In order to create a website, there are various web pages has to be designed, and all the web pages should be connected with each other with the help of the hyperlink option. So with the help of the HTML, you can create the hyperlink option, and with this option you can create all the web pages together. The next point is that I had told you earlier, that you need a web browser in order to open a website. So there is no any restriction that the web page is created by this HTML language, only this web browser can be used. you can use any type of web browser. When you are trying to open a web page, you can have any type of a web browser, and with the help of that particular web browser you can open your page easily. There is no any specific web browser is recommended in order to open the page. And HTML is not case sensitive language, means case sensitivity means that if you had write small a and the capital A, as you are all aware about the passwords when you are created in the Gmail, and if you have created a password with a small letter and you are entering it with a capital letter, it will show that you had entered an incorrect password. So this is what case sensitivity, that you are typing the same letter but in different case, is not acceptable. So in the this is called a case sensitivity, but HTML is not a case sensitivity language. As you can see, that is written here, the head in the capital letter and head in the small letter having the same meaning. So these are the few characteristics of the HTML. Simply you can say it is an easy language, it is not a case sensitive language. You can provide links with help of these languages, and you can accommodate many type of files in your web page in a single web page. Now the topic that I am going to discuss, that is tags. As I told you earlier, in the coming slide I will discuss about the tag. So what is tag? Tags are the simple HTML commands. So if we are using a command that are simple by using when we are creating a web page, then this type of commands that what we are using is called the tag. Tag can be used with the help of the sign of the greater than and the smaller than, as it is written here. You can see as the name of the tag enclosed between the arrow parenthesis, means between the greater than sign and less than sign, you have to use tag in the similar way. Now the tags can be of two types. First one is container type tag and the second one is empty tag. So you should know that the tag, once you open a tag, the tag should be closed also, means the tag having the similar opening and closing tag, then these type of tags are called the container tag. And when any tag is a simple opening tag, there is no any closing tag is there, so this type of tag are known as the empty tag. So the container tag name as the container tag because between the opening tag and between the closing tag there are some text that you want to print on the web page is there, and if their tag is empty, so it contains nothing because there is no any opening tag and the closing tag. In the similarly, as you can see, the example of the HTML is given here. The HTML tag is there, and the first one, that is HTML, is opening tag, and the slash HTML is the closing tag. All the file, all the document that you want to show on a single web page is written between the HTML opening and HTML closing tag. So these type of tag is known as the container tag. So in the coming slide you can see that how you can use the opening tag and how you can use the container tag. Now here you can see what are the right way to use the tag. That in the similar way, that first, if you had opened the tag number 1 and then tag number 2, you should close the tag number 2 first and then you will have to close the tag number 1. Means if you are opening the tag in the sequence, you will have to close the tag in the opposite direction. Means first, if you had opened the 1, then 2, then you will have to close the tag in the different way. First of all, you will have to close the tag, that is the tag number 2, and then the tag number 1. So this is the way through which you can open and close the tags. Here is a simple HTML program. You can see the simple HTML structure program here. First of all, you will have to open the HTML tag. So this tag informs the web browser that the tag you are using or the language you are using is the HTML language. So this is the very first tag of your document that you will have to open before writing anything in your notepad. So the first tag you will have to open, that is HTML tag. After that, your whole web page is divided into two sections. The first section is the head section and the second section is the body section. The head section deals with the title bar of your web page, as you all should aware about the title bar, that what is title bar. So the head section of your web page is dealing with the title bar of your web page, and the rest of the content is written in the body part. So mainly there are two part of the HTML program. First one is the head and the second one is the body. In the head tag, you will have to write the title tag. It will be displayed in the title bar of your web page, and rest of the section, whatever you want to write in your web page, should be written in the body part. From here onwards, I am going to discuss few tags. So the first tag that what I am going to discuss, that is HTML tag. So as I had told you earlier, that HTML tag is used to tell the browser that the language you are using in the web page is the HTML. And the HTML tag has two part, at the head part and the body part, as you had seen in the previous slide. The second tag that what I am going to discuss is the font tag. So before starting with the tag, you should be aware of the term font. So what is font? Basically, font can be understanding if you can resemble it with the term handwriting, as everyone has a different handwriting and the different type of letters everyone is making in the copy. So similarly, there are different type of fonts, or the you can say the different type of handwriting is available in the e-document. So what type of handwriting you want in your web page can be selected with the font tag. What is the size of the letter that what you want to use? What is the color of the letter that what you want to use? For example, if you want the any cursive type of handwriting, so you can choose the font accordingly. So font tag is used to select the way through which you want your text will appear on the web page. The color of the font, the size of the font, the face of the font, everything you can select with the help of the font tag. The next tag that what I am going to discuss is heading tag. So what we do usually when we write any type of heading in a copy, we write in a bold manner, like it should be some darker, or it should be some larger than the other part of your copy. So there are six heading tags are available, starting with the H1 to H6, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. But as its names appear, the biggest heading size you can get with the H1 tag, and the lowest or the smallest heading size you will get with the H6 tag. So there are six heading tags. This is an important part of your HTML. Now there are some common tags that you can, if you are using MS Word, and if you had learned MS Word, you can easily understand it, like bold, italic and underlined. These are the three tags through which you can make your font more attractive and more impressive, more communicative, by making it your font like bold, like italic, like underlined. So when you had studied the MS Word, the keyboard shortcuts that all you had used, that is Control plus B, Control plus U and Control plus I, in order to make your font italic, bold and underlined. Similarly, here you can use the tag, that is B, U and I, to make your font accordingly, that is bold, italic and underlined. So these are the three tags through which you can make your text more attractive.
The next is body background. So if you what is the body background? Body background is the background of your web page. So if you want to attach any image, similarly you can change your wallpaper in your phone, or you can change the wallpaper of your desktop. In the similar way, if you want to change the background of your web page, so you can do with help of the body background color. So the body background attribute is that, so that with the help of body background you can change the background of the image. And BG color is also used to change the background color of your web page. Align attribute is similarly like the alignment you had already studied in MS Word, like left align, center align and the right align. So there are four type of alignment technique in the align attribute. And the BR tag and the HR tag is used to draw a simple line. If you want to draw a line, you will have to use the HR tag. And similarly, if you want to break the line or break the paragraph, you will have to use the BR tag.